TV's culture segment. Here we are at Hull University's gallery, and it was formed in 1963, and we're going to be looking at five pieces today, so I hope you enjoy. Let's go have a look. So this sculpture is by Frank Dobson. It's called Cornucopia. It was made around 1925. It's also got a bronze study of the head figure in the Tate Gallery, also in the Fitzwilliam Museum in Cambridge. There's also the whole figure bronze study, also done there. Very nice artwork, I'd say. So this part of the gallery is called Back to Nature, and a lot of these pieces were done due to them feeling that nature would, they were fearing that it was in danger. So here's this piece by Ethelbert White called Edge of the Village, and it was made in 1924. And the funny story behind part of this is that him and his wife retired to a cottage, and they had all of their groceries catered to them by Harrods. And for this piece, this is by Sir Jacob Epstein. This whole collection is by Sir Jacob Epstein. And this piece is of the portrait of Joan Greenwood, an actress. And this was done when she was a child. She was also friends with Jacob Epstein's daughter, Peggy. So last but not least, this is our star painting of the gallery. It is by Sir Stanley Spencer, and it is called Villagers and Saints. And this painting is also somewhat autobiographical to Spencer's life. And within this, you see the people in the white, and they're represented as the saints. They're also not supposed to be seen, in a sense, but it's also supposed to mean that the dead is still with the living. So after viewing about a couple of these pieces in the gallery, I hope you've enjoyed it. And if you'd like to check it out, it's open 7 days a week, 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. And on Tuesdays, it's open a little bit later, till 7 p.m. And I'm Katie, this is Hullfire TV. And coming up, watch for an interview with Ryan Smith, the director of Breathing Corpses.
Hello, my name is Ryan Smith. I'm part of Hull University Drama Society, and in this semester I'm directing a play called Breathing Corpses by Laura Wade. Breathing Corpses is a modern mystery slash drama which takes place across three separate storylines with three separate groups of people. Now, these groups of people have never met before in the play, nor do they ever meet in the play. And at first it can seem a little bit confusing because they're different storylines. It seemed to be irrelevant. As the play progresses, however, little clues and hints are dropped here and there to imply that everything is not as it seems, and that in fact, these three groups of strangers, their lives are all intertwined in this kind of butterfly effect that takes place, this chain of events. And as the play goes on, you become more and more intrigued, and as more hints get dropped, you start to piece everything together gradually. And by the end, I've seen the play before myself, by the end of the play, the whole audience is, it has that effect of the whole audience is kind of going, oh, I didn't know that, so that was related to that, and oh, and it just makes you want to see the whole thing again. It's an incredibly clever script, and it's been a very dynamic play to work around with. And the experience has been wonderful. Yeah. What genres? It is quite difficult. Breathing Corpses. It does pretty much defy categorization. It is definitely a mystery, as it does sort of have you sort of looking around for clues as to who the suspect is. And as the title Breathing Corpses might suggest, there are corpses in the play. Three across the three separate storylines. These corpses, the methods of death and the killers, they're all unrelated at first, but as it goes on, you can see that there is a pattern, a change. The play is going to be on in Asylum. It's coming soon on the 3rd, 4th and 5th of May. That is a Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. It is cheaper for students, so please do come along. It's £4 to come along. Drama Society, we're all about promoting culture and theatre, and it's on an asylum. We want to show people that Asylum's not just a nightclub. You can go along for different things, such as plays and dance and all different parts of culture. So yes, please do come along and see that. You will not be disappointed.
This April saw a fashion show hosted in Johnny Mac, starring students of Hull University on the catwalk. The event was a success with over 50 people attending, with a variety of new styles on show. Join us for more culture segment after September.